First of all, you should know what is a programming language. It's a software category, right? We have three different categories, basically, like a programming language, operating system, and the packages. Operating system, you know, it's a Windows and Linux. There are many operating systems in the market. Then package. Package, nothing but MS Office and the PowerPoint. These are all package. Then programming language. There are many programming language type of software in the market, like C++, C, Java, Python, PHP. Why they are call it as a language? We should understand, right? Do you know, anyone know why we are call it as a language?
Through this, we can command computer the what we want the output, and he can perform that work function.
Okay. Generally, using language, what we can do, language, in the real time, day by day, we'll use language, right, to speak Tamil, English, and Hindi, whatever it is. Okay, that is, using that language, we can express ourselves to other person. Language is a medium. Using that, we can communicate one person to another person. Okay, let's say I am saying to my mother, I am very tired, I need a coffee. My mother understanding whatever I am speaking, based on that, my mother preparing a coffee and they give it to me. That coffee is called as output. Okay, I'm giving some input to my mother. He is listening that input. He is taking that input. Based on that input, she is performing some task and they given. And given to me, that is the final output is coffee. I'm asking coffee to her, it finally is giving the coffee. So language is for communicating each other. Similarly, programming language for to speak with computer. Programming language for to speak with computer. If you want to perform, if you want to give some information to the computer, if you want to talk to computer, we have to learn language. Programming language. There are many type of programming language. There are many type of program language in the market, like C++, C, whatever it is. 1 minute, people are asking to coming. Okay. 1 minute, guys. I'm going to change the settings. Whoever want to join, they can. Without my permission, they can join. Okay. So programming language for to talk to computer. Okay, that is the simple definition of programming language. Okay, in the programming language, we have two category of programming language. One is high level programming language, another one is low level programming language. High level and low level programming language. What is high level programming language? High level programming language easy to learn. There are whatever programming language we are learning, all languages are high level programming language. All languages are high-level programming language. What is low-level programming language? There are two types of low-level programming language. One is assembly language, another one is machine language. Okay, assembly language and machine language. This kind of language we cannot learn. It's very difficult. Okay, machine language only understand by processor. Only understand by processor. Okay, for example, machine language code is 0101 something kind of code available in the machine language that we cannot learn. That is understand by computer processor. And high level language is understand by human. High level language cannot understand by computer processor. Okay. Let me open one thing. High level languages are Java, C++, everything is high level language. Let's say user writing a program in high level language. That high level language is converted to low level language. High level language convert to low level language. That is low level language only computer processor understand. Your processor read that low level language and based on that instruction give the output to the person. That is the flow. This is the high level flow. Okay, we are writing a program in high level language that converted to low level language. That low level language read by computer processor, then it's reading the computer processor. Based on that information, it's giving some output to end user. Okay, this is the this is the process happening in the behind the scene. Whatever programming language you are doing, either Java, C++, finally it will go convert as a low-level language called machine language. That machine language read by the processor, read the information and given to the end user. Let's say this is a calculator. This assume that this calculator is a people are keep on coming here. Sorry guys. Okay, that's the reason I'm asking to join very sharp. But there is a calculator, right? This assume that this is a calculator. Okay, now in this calculator, this assume that this is a computer. I'm providing 2 + 5. 2 + 5. 2 is our information, plus is the information, 5 is information. There is a 3 different data I am inputting here. 3 different data I am inputting here. Whenever say equal to also input. So 2 + 5 equal. If I inputting 4 different input, it's your computer reading this information. Based on that information, whatever output it can give, that output is given by this computer. The output is given, the output is 7, right? It's reading a 2, reading a plus, it's reading a 5 and reading a equal, processing this data and finally it calculating 2 number and giving the final output is 7. Like programming language also very similar. We will going to provide some instruction to the programming language. Through the programming language, your programming language read that information. Through the programming language, your computer read the information and then finally giving the some output. Okay. How to give the information to the computer through our programming language? For example, if you want to learn some language, what you will do? We need to learn some letters. Right? After learning the letters, we need to learn some words. After learning words, we need to learn grammar. Then only we can form a sentence. Very similarly, in programming language also, first we need to learn keywords equal to letter, language letter. Keyword equal to language letter. Whatever language you want to learn, first you should know about the keywords. And all language in the market having its own set of keywords. Okay, using that keywords only we can write a program. After that, once you learn the keywords, this keywords equal to letter. After learning the letter, we need to learn the grammar, how to form the sentence. Okay, in the programming language, very similar thing is syntax. To know the syntax, a rule how to use the keyword. It says how to use the keywords to write a program. Syntax is nothing but how to use the keywords to write a program. It's very similar to grammar. If you know the syntax, then only you can write a program perfectly. So if you want to write a program, you should know keyword. What is the keyword? Then you should know rules, how to use that keyword. That is the syntax. Using syntax, you come to know that how to use a keyword to write a program. Okay. Then let me Google it. I will show you the keywords. I am saying C++ keywords. So this is a C++ keywords. Without this keyword, we cannot write any single line of program. We have to use this keyword. If you say Java keyword, this is Java keywords. This is Java keyword. Using this keyword only we can write a program. Okay. This keyword is helpful to write a program. Then syntax, there is some rule. How to use that keyword in your program. Using this keyword and syntax rules, we have to give information to the computer to perform a particular task. Okay, Then what is a variable? You should know what is a variable. For example, here I am passing 2 plus 5, right? You are passing some value. 2 is one value, 5 is a value. I want to manipulate this value 2, value 5. Okay. Then I want to store that value in a particular location. In a particular location. For that, we need to use variables. Variable is a container. Variable is a container where we can store certain amount of value. That value can be either number, either string, either anything. Image data, whatever it is. Using variable, we can store certain amount of value. Okay, that value manipulated in your program. Okay. Now I want to talk to the computer, meaning we need to install one programming language. Okay, for that we need to download, right? We need to download from the net and we need to install, we need to configure. That is the first step. I hope you understand what is a low level language, what is the high level language, what is keyword, what is syntax, what is variable. If you have any question, you can ask. Are you clear? What is keyword? What is the use of keyword?
Yes.
So syntax, what is use of syntax? Syntax, yeah. Is rule. It says it's kind of very similarly, it's a grammar. Okay, it's a grammar for English or Hindi, whatever it is. Okay. It says that how to use that keyword to write a program. Variable for the program. If you in the each and all the program manipulating the data. If you want to store any data, we need to use variable. Okay. Now next step is we will going to now download, install Java. We'll going to download and install the Java. How to download, how to install the Java, we'll going to see now. Okay. In my computer, I have already Java. And you see here OpenJDK. There's OpenJDK, JDK 11. I have JDK 11 installed. Okay. Now I'm going to remove that. I removed now. And now I don't have Java in my system. Then I'm going to remove the configuration. Whatever configuration I have, I'm going to remove. The path also I'm going to edit. Delete. So this will be very useful for new people to installing and downloading, installing the Java software. Okay. Just to type it JDK. jdk.java.net. We have to install OpenJDK. Okay. jdk.java.net. Here I want to install Java 11. Click 11. Then here is the Linux and the Windows, right? Click Windows. I have already there. 1 minute. I'm going to remove that also. Then click here. Click this. It will ask. Download it. Downloaded. Now I'm going to extract here. So we have a JDK folder coming. Just copy this folder, copy this or cut this folder and paste it to wherever you want in your operating system. Okay. I'll go to create a new folder called OpenJDK. OpenJDK. Then paste that folder, whatever folder you downloaded. Paste it here. Let me open command prompt. Copied OpenJDK, right? CD OpenJDK. Very clever. Okay. In the under JDK, there is one folder called bin folder. The bin folder, you can see lot of library files. Apart from there is application files. application files. You can see Java, C and Java. We'll going to use section file Java and Java C, and we're going to use Java P and jar file. These are all some commands. In this application file, each application file acts as a command. We can say this as a tool. This each tool used for particular purpose. For example, if you write a program, okay, I want to see the output of the program. For example, let's say here I'm saying 2 plus 5. I want to write a program to add a 2 number in Java. I want to see the output. Okay, for that, what we have to do? We need to compile. First, we need to compile the Java program. Then we need to run the Java program. In order to compile, in order to run, we need to use some commands. Okay, for that, we need to use Java C command. See here, there is a Java C.exe. That is the exe file for to compile a particular Java program. This is for Java user to see the Java output. Whatever program you have written, if you want to see the output of that program, we need to use Java command. Okay. Now I'll go in the command prompt. I'm going to bin folder. I'm going to this particular location. You can see here Java C. So it's giving some error now because I'm not passing anything. I have given Java C only. Okay. We have to say Java C and the pass.java. If you want to write a program, we need to create a one Java file. That Java file, the Java file must be extended with .java. Okay. Let's say I'm saying Java C pass.java. Now it's clearly saying file not found. Pass.java is file not found, it's saying. Okay, because I have not created any file now. Okay, Java C for to compile a Java program, and Java for to execute a Java program to see the output. Now in the bin folder, I can able to invoke this particular command. When I say like this, Java C compiler checking this particular file is available or not. If it is not available, it clearly says the file not found. Okay, now I am going to some other folder. I'll go into some other folder, let's say I'm going to insert a Suresh folder. Now here I'm going to say Java C. Now when you say Java C, here it says Java C is not recognized. Java C is not recognized. But when you available here, it's working. It is working, right? But when you go inside the Suresh or some other location of in your operating system, Java C is not working. But I want to work. I want to make it work all places with Java C command. I want to work all places with Java C command. For that, we need to do some setup. Okay. There is one variable called path variable. In our operating system, there is one variable called system variable called path. In the path variable, we need to tell to the computer where is your Java commands are exist. Where is your Java commands are available? We need to tell to that path variable. Then only your operating system recognize Java C command if you use anywhere. Otherwise, we need to use only in this location. How to do that? Let me print what is there in path command, path variable. So this is a path variable. Currently, this path variable having this many values. These are system path values. For example, let's say here you can see D colon Python. I installed the Python also. So the Python path variable available here. Similarly, we need to tell Java path also here. Okay. Now I'm going to set the Java path now. For that set, path equal to percentage path. Colon, then we need to tell this entire path. Meaning of this line is set path equal to percentage path. Meaning of this line is I don't want to erase the existing path. These are system path, right? We should not lock this. We have to keep this. Okay, I want to use the existing path. Apart from that existing path value, I want to add one more new path here. That is the meaning of this. Okay. Now I'll going to say enter. Now if you print this statement, you can see here D colon open JDK, JDK-11/bin is coming. Now in the path variable, I have added my Java path also. Now if you say Java C, it will work. Now in the decoder itself, I am saying Java C first dot Java. Now Java C command is working. It's clearly saying file not found. Now I can use this Java command anywhere. Java C first dot Java. Now I'll going to exit from the command prompt. I'll going to open again. If you say Java C, again it will not work. Okay. If you set path variable in the command prompt, it is available only in that window. Okay. Once you close that, it the value you set is lost. The whatever value whatever path value you set, that is lost. That value only available, only that command is active. Once you close, that will lost. Okay. So you need to set again. To avoid this problem, we need to set this path variable value permanently. We need to set this path variable value permanently. For that, we need to go to environmental variable. Type en, it shows this. Otherwise, go to this computer, right click properties, there is a system, advanced system settings, click environmental variable, click path, then edit, then go copy this path, then here double click it, otherwise click new, then paste it. That's it. You added a new path value in your path variable. You added new path value in your path variable. Then click OK. Once you done like this, this is a permanent solution. Okay. Whenever you open command prompt, you can easily access anywhere. Now it's work anywhere. This is a permanent solution. Okay. If you set path variable inside a command prompt, in the command prompt, that is a temporary solution. It is available only until you close that window. Once you close that window, that configuration vanish. Okay. Better solution is you need to go to the system variable where you need to set the your path value there. Okay. I hope you understand this, right? Any doubt? Any question? Hello?
No, sir.
No.
Okay, good.
No question.
Got it right? How to set the path? Okay, now we have configured the download the Java and we have configured. We have downloaded the Java and we have configured. Okay. Now we need to write one first program. We need to write one simple program. We'll see that how to write the simple program. Okay. I will use normal text editor, Notepad. So if you want to write a program, I told that we need to use the keywords. We need to use keywords, right? Without keywords, we cannot write a single enough program. Okay. The Java keyword, you can see there is one keyword called class. If you want to create a Java program, we need to create one file. That file must be extended with .java. Then if you want to write a program, we need to start with keyword class. Then we need to provide what is the class name. I am saying class name is a first. Then open the braces, close the braces. Okay. This is the rule of using class. Using class, we can create a class. If you want to create a class, we need to use the class keyword. Then we need to provide what is that class name. Then open the braces, close the braces. Inside this body, we need to write a program. Then public static void main string args. First, you save this file as a .java file. This is text editor, right? When you save in text editor, either you have to select Java file type, otherwise you need to say whatever class name you are provided here. Okay, that file name, you need to give as a file name. Okay, first 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 Java. Within double quotes you have to give, because I'm saving as a .txt file here. When you select a .txt file, you need to say, we need to pass your Java file name within double quotes. Okay, save it. Once you save it, it's highlighting that keywords and all different color. It's highlighting the keywords and all different color, right? My class name is a first. Then inside that I am saying public static void main. This public static void main is a predefined function. It's a predefined function that we have to use. Okay. You need to understand. You need to understand that if you want to run any program, that particular Java file must have a main method, main function. Without main function, we cannot run any Java program. For public static void main, there is a each word, there is a meaning. Okay. I will explain those meaning later part of the session. Okay, if you explain today, you will get confused. As of now, you understand that if you want to run any Java program, we need to use public static void main string args. Okay, inside this main function, this is a main function. Okay, inside the main function, we need to write our program. Okay. Writing one single line program, system.out.println. This is my first Java program. System.out.println is a statement for printing a particular statement in a console. If you want to print some statement in a console, we need to use system.out.println. You need to remember it. Okay, system. But we have some meaning for this. What is system? What is out? What is println? Okay. These things I will go to explain upcoming videos. Upcoming session. Now you need to understand how to print some value in the monitor. In the monitor, we need to use system.out.println. Then you need to pass some statement. This is my Java program. Now if you want to see the output, what you have to do, first we need to compile a program. So this is a high level program, right? This is a high level program. This high level program understand only human. The computer program never understand. We need to convert this as a machine code. Okay. Convert this as a machine code. For that we need to compile and execute. Okay. What is the command for compile? I told previously, if you want to compile any Java program, we need to use Java C command. Okay. My program is available in this folder, right? Session 1, there is a first.java. I created here and now I want to compile this. We need to go to that particular location. Here you can see first.java. Now I can say Java C first.java. Once you compile this Java compiler, create one more file. That file called first.class. Here you can see compile first.class. When you open this first.class, you don't understand anything. It has some junk code. This code we can call it as a bytecode. Okay, this code we call it as a bytecode. Okay, this bytecode only understand by your Java runtime environment. I will explain about Java runtime environment later session. Okay, this. Whenever you compile this particular Java file, .java file converted as a .class file, the .class will contain some junk character. Okay, this junk character cannot understand by human. This can understand only Java runtime environment. Okay, Java runtime environment. I'm going to explain more detail about Java runtime environment later part of the session. Okay, now we need to give this .class file to our Java runtime environment. How to do that? Okay, now I compiled, I generated the first dot class. Now I want to see the output. If you want to see the output, we need to run that dot class file. How to do that? Java followed by first. Java followed by PuffJava. Whatever file you compiled. Now I compiled PuffJava. PuffJava generated one more class called PuffClass. Now I want to run that PuffClass using Java command. Whenever you say Java, the class file name, it will read this file. According to that file instruction, it gives the output to us. Okay. See, this is my first Java program. In my Java program, what I did, just I'm printing, this is my first Java program. That's it, right? And whenever say Java first, what will happen? It will read this instruction. Okay, this guy wanted to print some statement to the console. So it's taking that instruction and printing the statement to the console. That's it. So if you want to compile, we need to use Java C. If you want to run, we need to use Java. Okay, Java C for compiling Java file, Java for to see the output of your Java file. Okay. From the Java 8, right? Now we are working with Java 11. From the Java 10, I think. From the Java 10, we don't have to do Java C and Java. We can directly run Java. We can say that. For example, let's say I'll go to remove this Java file, Java dot class file. Okay. Now I have only PuffJava, right? Now I want to run this. I want to, since I'm using Java 11, we don't have to say Java C and Java. Directly you can say Java PuffJava. What will happen? This Java command on the fly, it will compile and it generate the dot class at runtime. Okay, in the behind the scene, generate the dot class file in the memory and read the dot class file and read the dot class file and then give the output according to the program, according to my program in the Java file. Okay. Any question? Any question?
No, Suresh.
Okay. So you understand how to write a simple Java program. So whenever you want to write a Java program, we need to start with class keyword. Okay. Class keyword. Then we need to provide a name of that particular class. Then we need to open the braces, close the braces, particular class. This is the body of the class. Inside the body of the class, we have to use main method. We have to use main function. Okay, that inside the main function only we need to write our program. We need to write a program. All our programs start from here. Whenever you say Java C, so whenever you say Java, first what will happen? This particular Java command read from here. It will check this particular Java file contain main method or not, main function or not. I will say main function or method. Okay, both are same only. Whenever you say Java first, your command go and check this particular first class file contain main method or not. If it is main method, it will go under execute all the program. Whatever program I have written here, it will go on to execute. Okay. So now I want to perform this particular task, 2 plus 5. This add task I want to perform. I told, right, if you want to manipulate any information, in the program, we need to use variable. Using variable, we can store some amount of data. Through that variable, we can manipulate that value in our program. The value in our program. Okay. Now I'm going to declare one variable. If you want to create any variable, there are many keywords. Using that keywords only, we need to define a variable. Okay. We'll go to see the detail, more detail about the variable tomorrow. Okay. Now simply I want to define one variable called int. Int is a one keyword. Using int keyword, we can create a number type variable. we can create a number type variable. Int is a keyword. Using int keyword, we can create a number type variable. Now I can say int a. Now a is a variable name. A is a variable name. Variable name can be anything. Okay, so I can give, and here I am giving a as a variable name. Then equal to, I am saying 10. If you say like this, using int keyword, I am creating a variable called a. Then using this assignment operator, equal to operator, using this equal to operator, I am assigning one value to a variable. Now this a variable having one value called 10. Now I want to create one more variable, int b. Int b equal to 5. So again, I am creating one more variable called b. Then I am assigning one value 5 to that b variable. Now variable a is having a 10, variable b is having a 5 variable. Now I want to add these two number. Let's see how to do that. Int total. Now int total. Total is again another variable I'm creating using int keyword. Then a plus b. If you say like this, this plus operator is used for adding a two number. Now into total equal to a plus b, meaning a is having a 10, b is having a 5. So 10 plus 5, 15. The 15 value assigned to total variable. Okay. Now I want to print this value. Previously we used a system.out.println. I am printing, this is my first program. When you look at here, I am enclosed this value within double quotes. Right? Because whenever you print any string value, that value must be within single quotes. Within double quotes. That's the reason I am saying, I am giving this string value within double quotes. Okay. Now if you want to print any number value, you don't have to give that value within double quotes. We can directly print like this. out.println. I'm saying total here. So the line number six, I'm printing, this is my first Java program. Line number 8, I am creating a new variable called a using int keyword, then assigning the value called 10. Line number 9, I am creating another variable called b and assigning value 5 to b, Then again I am creating another variable, total int variable. Then here I am manipulating that variable a and a variable b. What I am doing here, I am adding two values, a plus b. When I say a plus b, whatever value stored inside the a variable, inside the b variable, both are added under the total value assigned to total variable. Finally, I want to print the total value here. So again, I'm using system.out.println, then total. Since this is a variable, just we have to print that variable value directly here. Okay. So I have changed some program, right? Now again we need to compile and execute. Now Java C, first.java. Where is that file? Spelling mistake. So file is compiled now. Java first. So this is my first Java program. Total value 15. Total value is 15 is printing. Okay. Understand? This small program.
Yes.
Okay. Now I want to print here total. I want to print here total equal to 15, something like that. I want to print something descriptive output. How to do that? I told, right, if you want to print any string value, that string value must be within a double quote. So here I'm saying double quote, within double quotes I'm saying total equal to plus. If you say like this, dot out of println, this total value just to print as it is in the console, just to print as it is in the console. Then this total variable value, whatever variable available in this total variable, that value will print here. Again, Java C is first. Since we are using Java 11, we can directly do like this. Java, we remove the class file. So we need to remove the old class file, okay, if you are running like this. Java C. This is my first Java program. I don't know why it's being like this. Maybe I am not saved. Okay. I think hope you understand how this is working.
Okay. Hello sir, I have one question.
Yeah.
Sir, in program, int total is equal to a plus b. After that, system dot out dot println, total is equal to plus total. Why is writing a plus total?
Yeah, the plus total is act as a concatenation. For example, here you may understand clearly, a plus b is adding this a value and b value as in total. This line is clear, right?
But sir, instruction is total is equal to a plus b. Directly we can write a total.
No. What I am trying to say is, here a plus b, a having a 10, b having a 5, we are adding total number using plus operator, then the total value assigned to total variable. Okay, but your confusion is here only for you, right?
Yes, sir.
This is a total string value.
Yes.
I am pasting that total string value with this number. Okay. With this number. Output is like this. What will happen here? Output is total coming like this. Total 15 equal to 15. This entire statement print as it is in the console. Okay, print as it is in the console. After that, whatever value stored inside the total variable, that value printing here. For example, if you print Suresh, if you print here Suresh, right? Suresh.
Yes.
What will happen?
Suresh is equal to 15.
Yeah, 15 will print.
Yes.
For descriptive output, I am saying here total equal to 15. Total equal to whatever total value is coming here. Okay.
Yes, sir. And this is the concatenation plus total.
This is a concatenation. Yeah, exactly. This is a concatenation. One more thing you notice here, I am saying double slash, right? This is a single line command. This command statement not a recognized part of the program. It's not a part of the program. Whenever you compile your program, your Java compiler ignore this statement. These statements are ignored, okay, by the compiler, because this is for only document purpose. Okay. This is a single line command. If you want to comment a multi-line, we can use like this.
Star. Okay, yes, yes.
You can use like this. Okay, this is a multi-line command. Now this entire line not recognized by the compiler. When I compile now, it's giving error. It will give error. When I compile this program. Java C. Let me. I have not saved the program. I have not saved that. Now it's giving the error. See?
Yes, sir.
Local variable, the in the location class first, variable total, symbol variable total cannot find the symbol total, clearly saying, because I commented out this section. Whenever you compile this, your compiler not consider this particular statement. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Now again I'm saving this. Okay, now it's coming. Okay. Then one more thing, we can declare one more type variable, string type variable, string. This is where we are storing only number of variable, right? If you want to store this kind of variable, this one, I want to store this kind of variable, for this kind of value. How to do that? For that, we need to use string type data, string type variable. String. String value equal to, now I want to assign this entire value here. Whenever say like this, string value equal to, this is my first Java program. What will happen? This entire value stored in value variable. Value variable. Here I am saying, here I am creating a one value variable using string class type. This is not a keyword. This string is not a keyword. I said this int is a keyword. Using int keyword, I created an int variable. But this is not a keyword. This is a class type. I will explain later about this. Okay. I don't want to confuse you now. Just assume that now I am creating a one variable called value using string type. Using string type. Now in that value, I am assigning one value called this is my first Java program. Now I want to print this value. For that, just we need to use this particular variable. That's it. Passing some almost some notes. Okay. Java C first Java. Java first. So this is my first Java program. It's coming from this variable. Coming from this variable. I am printing that variable value using system.out.println. Okay. One more thing, the system.out.println, there is a ln keyword, right? Ln. Just to assume I'll remove that phrase. Ln. Let's see what is the difference. See, this is my first Java program followed by printing total. The same line, everything is printing. Because I removed ln. Ln nothing but creating a new line. Whenever you say print ln, it will print and create a new line. Create a new line. Then whatever statement you are printing after that, that line print next line. Okay, that is the meaning of ln. Understand? If I remove, what's happening? If this statement is printing, after printing the statement, this program execute. After executing this program, what will happen? The total value print in the same line. Print in the same. Immediately it will print here itself. That is the function use of print. If you want to print the next line, just we need to say ln. So when you say ln, what will happen? After printing this particular statement, it will create a new line. Then from the next line onwards, whatever system out of print we are using, that statement will print in next line. Okay. Now it's printing one by one. Okay, guys. I think we'll close today. We'll start again tomorrow.
Hey, Suresh. Suresh, can you provide PPT to us?
What do you want?
PPT, whatever we'll use in the classroom.
Do you want that? Okay, yeah, I will share that, yeah.
Yes.
Are you okay with this class today?
Yeah, sure, super.
Okay.
And video also uploaded?
Yeah, video will be saved in cloud, I will share it later, okay?
Okay, sure.
Thank you, man, thank you. Thank Please you. Ask, 1 minute. I'll stop the video.
Still not subscribe this channel, please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.